Andrea. Woo! Andrea, come and join us.
Hello everyone, I am a graduate student in the creative writing department, and I actually just wanted to read a letter to you that 26 of us students, faculty, and alumni from the creative writing and writing and performing arts program here signed in response to the events of January 19th, and we hand-delivered it and emailed it to the chancellor last Friday. So I'm going to go ahead and read it. We have not yet received a response, but I know he's going to be courteous enough to give one to us. But here we go. Dear Chancellor White, as graduate students, teaching assistants, alumni, and faculty from the MFA program for creative writing and writing for the performing arts at UC Riverside, it's a mouthful, we are deeply disappointed by the actions taken by the university last Thursday, January 19th. We participated in the campus-wide action comprised of UC students, faculty, and staff outside of the hub, while the UC Regents continued their meeting in privacy. This day-long action is indeed an expression of outrage over rising tuition and depreciating quality of education. It was also a celebration of community and solidarity. We witnessed our students chanting or engaging in discussions about the grim future of UC Riverside. For many of them, this was their first political protest. One of our students, a mother of two, brought her three-year-old daughter. This student lamented forgetting to dress her daughter in her Highlander shirt. She wanted her daughter to bear witness to the fight for her future education. We witnessed UCR students and community members dressed in black, bearing colorful life-size banners, right here, depicting the book covers of liberatory texts. These books envision equality and freedom and question privilege and cultural hegemony, such as Frantz Fanon's The Wretched of the Earth, Bell Hooks's Feminism is for Everyone, and Paulo Freire's Pedagogy for the Oppressed, which has been banned in Arizona, among others. The book block remained at the front of the line, protecting protesters as they faced a staggering number of riot police at the hub exit. We couldn't help but recognize the clear metaphor in all of this. Despite what your Friday letter states, and I know y'all have read the Friday letter by this point, there were more than just a few individuals at this action. We witnessed hundreds of students and staff and faculty who merely wanted to engage in an open discussion with the UC Regents. As police helicopters circled above us, we witnessed your students, pushed, shoved, and humiliated by riot police because of this desire to converse and be heard by the Regents. We witnessed members of our community shot by police officers with paint pellet guns. One young man was knocked to the ground by the shock and force of these pellets. We witnessed sheer violence by your co-workers, the police, who instead of marching around the students to take their positions, marched directly through the crowd as if they wanted to incite the kind of riot they were brought in to quell.
Yeah.
However, in your Friday letter, you failed to acknowledge the many injuries that UCPD and several outside law enforcement agencies inflicted upon your students, injuries that were also ignored by many major news outlets who I'm sure are here today. Yeah. We believe that UCR students deserve an explanation and an apology. The few individuals who peacefully disrupted the UC Regents meeting represent more than a handful of marginal opinions. And they're not just fucking outsiders either. Give your students more credit. These few individuals exercise an essential act of civil disobedience and represent many of us in the UC Riverside and UC community who are fed up with business as usual. We urge you to provide opportunities for students to engage in dialogue, such as a public forum or town hall, about last Thursday's events and the implications behind police presence as the university's response to student assembly and protest. We urge you to take responsibility for putting your student safety on the line. We urge you to ensure their safety and right to express their discontent with the UC system by supporting future student action. Sincerely, the undersigned.
Yeah.
Sorry, probably went a little bit over time. One last thing, UC Artists is having a meeting. This is a group, a collective of artists on campus, writers, dancers, musicians, however you want to call yourself an artist, having a meeting at 5 p.m. tonight, 4120 INTS. You can ask me afterwards if you want more.
Free pizza!
Alright, everybody, we will continue free speech at the police station.